every child is important. Every child deserves to feel like they are special and that they mean something.
For 11 years, Amanda McGill and her husband Brett have opened their home and hearts to 36 children whose parents couldn't look after them.
Sometimes those kids have really brave faces on when they walk in. And it's not until they feel safe and secure that you start to see all the real hurt. We've had emergency placements before where kids have come in on a Friday night at 8 o'clock at night and they're scared. They've never been to this house before.
Amanda and Brett's five sons do their utmost to make the newcomers feel at home.
They bring them in and say, this is going to be your bedroom, this is what we do at dinner time, pop yourself to fruit whenever you like.
What do the children need most when they arrive?
They need to know that they can wake up tomorrow and have breakfast and have a bed to stay in again tonight. You know a child's starting to feel safe when they know how to stop after two or three serves of dinner, when they're not hiding food under their bed anymore because they're worried about where their next meal's coming from.
A child enters the foster care system every 45 minutes. Anastasia was one of them. She landed on Amanda's doorstep when she was just 9 months old.
She was a really much welcomed Christmas present. We got her Christmas Eve in 2009.
Yep. Not too long after, her little sister Zoe arrived too.
Sometimes this happens where a mum will have another baby and it's still not safe for that child to go home. So we picked Zoe up from the hospital at 6 days old.
How long did it take Anastasia to realise that's your little sister?
It took a little while. We just had to keep explaining it to her. But once she picked it up, they're inseparable. So that's good.
What do you remember about how you felt when you first came to be with your now mum and dad?
I felt scared because I didn't sort of know them. But as the years grew on, I have known them a lot more better.
What do you guys know about your birth parents?
That my mum has psoriasis like me.
And that they took drugs when I was in the tummy.
When it became clear the girls couldn't go back to their biological family, Amanda and Brett decided to adopt them.
Anastasia, tell me about Forever Day.
It's where you get to celebrate of you being adopted. So we make cupcakes and bring them to school.
We normally have smiles on our hands with permanent marker.
Do you ever wonder what life would have been like if Amanda and Brett hadn't adopted you?
Yes. We would probably be living in
a dumpster.
Yeah, probably.
What makes you think you would have been living in a dumpster?
Because our parents have mostly been spending their money on alcohol, all that.
Drugs.
Knowing that these kids have often come from very difficult circumstances, what sort of relationship do you have towards their biological parents?
We have to bring them in as part of our family and we want to bring them in. They were the child's first parents. And if you want that child to feel that security and safety, then it's really important that you nurture that relationship with their parents.
Amanda knows this because she's been that child.
I was placed in foster care as a newborn baby and then adopted, you know, a little while later. I was born in the era of a closed adoption, so I grew up hearing stories but not knowing the truth. Adoption was a dirty word. There was a great stigma, you know, it was like a secondhand kid almost. I guess that's probably a great way to describe how I felt.
That breaks my heart.
Aww. My childhood has really shaped who I want to be as a mum. Our girls that we've adopted, we make sure that they know the story of why they came into foster care and why they were adopted. And they don't feel the shame and the stigma of the ugly words adoption and foster care.
We know that there are still plenty of children that are falling through the cracks in the foster care system. Why do you think that is?
I think that the department and the agencies need more staff. They need more eyes at the child's level. We need greater support for kids when they are in care, when they're entering care.
What's the hardest part of being a foster carer?
Seeing the trauma that a child's been through, and I guess also I'm really pro-restoration and I don't like it when that breaks down and they can't see their birth family.
How attached do you get to the kids?
Very. They're not foster kids, they're kids, they're our kids, so that's how we've treated them. So when we've had to move them on or they've gone back to their parents, it rips you to pieces, but it's, you know, it's for the greater good.
I always like to write a child a letter and tell them all of the positive stuff about what we really enjoyed the most, how much we've seen them grow, let them know all of those little milestones.
What's the kindest thing Mum has ever done for you, Zoe?
Taking us into her life.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say.
Yeah? That's a pretty big thing, isn't it?
Yeah.
And Amanda and Brett don't do things by halves. They're now in the process of making a forever home for another pair of young siblings, which will take their brood to 9.
We are on the adoption pathway now for twin boys that came into our care for a short while, about 5 years ago, and they stayed. And we have the support of their mum to adopt the boys.
How would you describe home for the kids?
It's always loud and crazy, but there's always safety and predictability, yeah.
Will this house ever be empty?
I hope not. I think it's at capacity for now, but I certainly hope it's never empty.
I tell you what, when you walk into Amanda and Brett's home, you realise that it does take a village to raise a child because their older boys all pitch in and they're all passionate about improving the lives of all of the kids that have come through the door, and it's more than 30 at this stage.
Wow.
Amanda and Brett have not had a holiday in 24 years, and wouldn't you know it, they had their first holiday planned next month to go to the Gold Coast. They live in Sydney. Not going to happen. And Amanda, you're a champion. You do 4 to 5 loads of washing a day. I take my hat off. And if you would like more information about becoming a foster carer, you can find all the links on our website. That's all we have.